In this session, let us talk about var-args. Var-args means variable argument list. It is like a expandable array. A var-args can take 0 to any number of values. Now, let us see the syntax for var-args. Access specifier, return type, method name. Everything is going to be similar, just like how you create a method. Var exactly is the change. The data type, which is followed by three dots. This is actually specifying that this is of type var-args. And you are going to give the variable name. That is, if I am going to give calculate int dot dot dot, three dots only, space x, it means when I am trying to call, I can call it either using calculate simply without any parameters, or calculate 10, or calculate 10, 20, means this is a variable argument which can take from 0 to any number of parameters. When you are using variable arguments or var-args, there are certain rules that has to be followed. The first thing is, you can have only one variable argument in a method. The variable argument should be the last parameter, that is the last argument. And the data type should be followed with three dots, that I have already told you. Okay, see a simple example, public void area int dot 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 x. So this is a variable argument. Can I write like this, say int dot 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 x comma int y? No, this has to be the last argument. This is a simple example for variable argument. I have got a method calsum which is taking a variable argument. The idea over here is I want to calculate the sum of marks. The argument list may differ, starting with 1, 2 or any number. Now, let us see the flow. I am trying to calculate the sum of marks by using a for each. What is b? B is a variable argument array. So, I am trying to use for each to calculate the sum. Now, let me try calling the calcsum method. I have already created an object. Yes, that calcsum of Ram. What will be the output? It will come and print welcome Ram. What about the array length? It is 0. It will not enter into the for loop. Then, trying to call yes dot calcsum of Tom and 90. What it will print? Welcome Tom and the sum will be 90. What will happen for the next, this one? John 20, 30, 40. Three times it will iterate over the for loop and it will print the sum. So, the output is going to be welcome John and sum 100. I hope this part is clear. So, this is a variable, this is a method having a variable argument. You have learned about the concept of overloading. What if I am having one more method having taking string name as argument? What will be the output for the first one? Yes dot calcsum of Ram. When I give like this, will it go to this or to this method? Always old is gold. It will go to this method only. This is from 1.5 Java, but this is a older version. So what will be the output now? It will print have a good day Ram. Okay. So the output will be have a good day Ram. So this is all about var-args. We will see an example for var-args in the next session. Thank you.